Hello friends, I welcome you to my channel Dev's Institute. Today we will see assembly language program for string manipulation operation using FAR procedure. So main aim of this video is to learn how to implement FAR procedures. Okay, so this is our problem statement. Write menu driven ALP assembly language program to perform string manipulations. The string to be accepted from user is to be stored in code segment module 1 and write FAR procedures in code segment module 2 to perform the following string operation. First operation is concatenation of two strings and comparison of two strings. This is the problem statement. So before going towards actual program, first we will see what is FAR procedure. Then the calling procedure and called procedure are written in two different code segments, then that procedure is called as FAR procedure. In my earlier video, we have seen various string manipulation operations like calculating length, finding reverse of the string, checking whether string is palindrome or not. But in that case, all the procedures were written in a single code segment. The single code segment contains the main code, then code for length, code for reverse, code to check the palindrome string, like this. So we directly call that procedure from the main procedure by its name. But now here, as it is given in a problem statement, in code segment 1, we have to write the code to accept the string from users, and in code segment 2 we have to write the procedure for concatenation of two strings and comparison of two strings. So see now how this is done. This is mod1.asm file, that is our module 1. A simple macro, just we write every time a simple macro to display message, is written over here. Then dot model small dot stack 100h dot data. This is our data section. In data section, we contain two strings, str1, str2, and these two strings are declared as a public, because in these strings str1 and str2 we are going to store the string entered by user, because we have to perform the concatenation and comparison operation. So we need two strings from user, and those two strings will be stored in str1 and str2 respectively, and that data type is declared as a public. So now we all know that once the data is declared as a public, it can be accessed from outside programs or from other codes as well. Okay, so this is str1, str2. We can see here, this is the data section of mod1, str1, str2, two strings declared here. See, str1, str2, 25 do dollar. So they are uninitialized. It contains the null character. Then these are different messages required throughout the program: enter string 1, enter string 2, menu, enter your choice, and enter correct choice. So these are the messages defined by 10, 13. We know that 10, 13 is required to take the string to the new line. So whenever this message is printed, enter string 1, it will be taken to new line and at the first character of the new line, and this dollar is nothing but the end of string, that is null character. Next is code segment. Now see here, in this code segment, this is our main procedure, and from main procedure we are calling this procedures: call concatenation and call comparison. So before calling this procedure, we must define this procedure. But as this is FAR, we are implementing FAR procedure, the procedures are written over here in this code mod2.asm. So to tell this to the program, we are writing these two statements. Extern, extern, extern is the keyword, extern concatenation colon FAR. That means that Concatenation is the procedure which is FAR procedure and declared externally. Similarly, extern comparison colon FAR. So here this concatenation procedure is written in mod2.asm here. Concatenation procedure FAR. And comparison, this comparison is written over here, comparison. Okay. So these two statements are very important to tell that concatenation comparison are two FAR procedures and they are declared in another another core segment. So this is start instruction. So normal procedure will start from here and this is the code to call the concatenation and comparison by checking the menu whether user enters 1, 2, that is okay. Now in mod2.asm again a macro is defined to display the message. Here extern str1 colon byte str2 colon byte means for concatenation and comparison we will require str1 and str2. STR1 and STR2 we are taking from user in this code mod1.asm. Here it is made public STR1, STR2 means STR1 and STR2 will be accepted here and it will be publicly available. Here in this code STR1 and STR2 are declared as a extern means STR1 and STR2 are these two strings which will be taken from external sources and they are of type byte. See here, they are of type byte. Okay, so the same statement is written to declare str1 str2 as external variables. Then message, simple message, concatenated strings, strings are equal, strings are not equal. Okay, and one str3 variable is declared to store the values of concatenated string. This str3 is declared in mod2 and this null character. Okay, and this is code segment of mod2 which contains the concatenation and comparison procedure. But now see here, it is written public concatenation and comparison means concatenation and comparison, these two procedures are public, means it can be accessed from other core section, and here they are declared as a external because we are calling it from external code segment. Okay, so now we will move towards code. This is the procedure for concatenation, this is procedure for comparison, that's it. Terminal and normal, termination, np, main, end, that's the normal rules we follow for writing the code. So now we will start with actual execution. Actual execution will start from this statement, start, move ax, data, move ds, x. This is normal we do for data segment initialization. Move ES, AX, extra segment, move extra segment, AX. This is required at the time you are using FAR procedure. If you are using for FAR procedure, then this statement is must. Move ES, AX. It is only the data segment's base address is stored in extra segment ES, that's it. Okay, then display message 1. Display message 1. The message 1 here is enter string 1. LEA DX STR1. DX is pointing to STR1. Move AH, 01H, INT 21H. So move AH, 0AH, INT 21H. What it will do? It will read the string entered by user and that string will be stored at address which is pointed by DX register. I repeat, These two instructions are used to read the string entered by user, and string entered by user will be stored at the address contained by DX register. So now DX register contains address of STR. So whatever entered by user, let's say user enters hello, it will be stored in STR, H-E-L-L-O. Then display message to enter string to LEADX STR2. Now DX contains the address of STR2. Move AH, 0 AH INT 21 H. Now suppose user enters string welcome. So welcome will be stored at STR2 because now DX register contains address of STR2. So the string entered by user will be stored at STR2. Okay. Next is menu, display message 3, 4, 5, 6. So this menu will be displayed. 1, concatenation, 2, compare, 3, exit and enter your choice. Okay. Now suppose user enters choice 1. So by this instruction, move AH, 01H, INT 21H. Processor will read the value entered by user and the value will be stored in AL register. So now AL register will contain 31 because ASCII value of the 1 is 31. Next instruction is move BL, AL. So by this, contents of AL will be transferred to BL register. So BL register contains 31. Compare BL, 31. So check whether the choice entered by user is 1. Jump if equal to concat, means if the value is 31, yes it is 31. Jump if equal, yes they are equal to concat. So what is written in concat? Concat, call concatenation. So now it will look for concatenation. Where concatenation is written? It is written here, but it is declared as a extern. Extern means it will go to mod2.asm. So here it is concatenation. Concatenation procedure FAR. It is declared as a FAR procedure. One more thing I want to mention here. Generally, when you execute the code, consider that this is command line. When you want to run the ASM file, what we do? Pasm mod1.asm. So it will create the assembly, means it will create the ASM file, and then we link it, tlink mod1, and then we execute just mod1, and it will give you, or it will show you the output. But here in this case, you have to compile both the files separately. So pasm mod1.asm, then pasm mod2.asm, then tlink mod1 plus mod2. So by this way you will link both the files, and then you have to use only the first name for execution, this mod1. So you will say just mod1 and enter, so your program will start executing. So you have to, I repeat, you have to compile both the files, pasm mod1.asm, pasm mod2.asm, then link mod1 first, and then, sorry, this is not required, sorry, pasm mod1.asm, pasm mod2.asm, and then tlink mod1 plus mod2, and then only the mod1. Okay, so we were here, this is concatenation procedure. Concatenation, move ch, 00, again ch. Now here this ch is from mod2, ch is 00, cl str1 plus 1. Str1 plus 1 means it will contain the length of str1, which is 5. So cl contains 05. So combining this will give you CX0005, because this CX will be required for this instruction. REPZ, repeat until 0, move SB. Okay, so CL05, which will make CX0005. Now LEA SI comma STR 1 plus 2. So now SI will point to first character from STR 1, and LEA DI comma STR 3 plus 2, means DI will point to first character from the STR 3. Now REPZ move SB, means repeat until 0, what? CX. Okay, repeat until 0, move SB. Now move SB instruction moves contains from the location pointed by SI to the location pointed by DI. We have seen this instruction in detail in last video, so I will not focus much on it now. If you want, you can go back to my previous video, string manipulation operations, and there you can see the explanation of this in detail. So after instruction of execution of this instruction, this hello will be copied here, and after copy SI will point here, because one by one, first this H will be copied, SIDI incremented, CX decremented, then again E will be copied, SIDI incremented, CX decremented. Likewise, procedure is repeated till this CX becomes 00, and when CX becomes 00, SI pointing at next location after STR1, and DI is pointing at next location after STR3. So this is how this hello is copied here. We are performing concatenation operation, means in this new string we must get this string and then this string. We have to concat these two strings, right? So this is done, first string is taken in STR3. Now again CH is 00, CH is 00, and CL is STR 2 plus 1, means length of this is 7, which will make CX 0007. LEA SI, now DI will be here only. Now we are updating SI to point to first location or first character of STR 2. So LEA SI STR 2 plus 2. So SI will come here. SI will point to first character of STR2. Again REPZ move SB. So all these characters will be copied to STR3. See here, all these characters copied here, and CX is now 00. Okay, now display message 1. So message 1 is concatenated string. Now concatenated string is present in STR3. So LEA SI comma STR3, move AH comma 09H, and LEA DX STR 3 plus 2, because string starts from STR 3 plus 2. So DX register will be pointing to STR 3 plus 2. Okay. And move AH comma 09H INT 21H, 09 code. The job of 09 code is to display the value which is present in DX, but now DX contains the address of string, this string. So it will display that string on the screen, that is hello welcome. So we got the concatenation string. String 1 was hello, string 2 was welcome. And so the concatenated string is hello welcome. Okay, so this is, and then return means it will go here, because the procedure was called from this line. So after this instruction, it is again jump menu, so it will again display menu concatenation. See, the strings are same, concatenation, compare and exit. Now suppose user enters 2. So user has entered instruction, user has entered choice 2. So by this instruction AL will be updated with 32. 32 is the ASCII value of 2. Then move BL, AL. BL will contain 32. Then compare BL with 32. Yes, jump if equal to compare. And so it will come here, call comparison. Now again, comparison here is external. So it will link, it will look for the comparison procedure in another ASM file, and another ASM file is here, comparison. Okay, now comparison, move CL comma STR 1 plus 1. So CL will contain length of STR 1, and CH will contain, move CH comma STR 2 plus 1. So CH will contain the length of STR 2. Now compare CH comma CL, compare these two register, because if the strings are equal, their length must be equal. But if their length is different, then no need to check the characters. If the length is different, that means strings are not equal. So compare CH comma CL 7 and 5. Jump if not 0 to down. So what this instruction do? Compare CH comma CL. It will perform CH minus CL operation. It will subtract this 5 from this 7. The result is 2, means 0 flag is not set. But if they are equal, means 7 7 or 5 5, 5 minus 5 is 0 or 7 minus 7 is 0, at that point 0 flag is set. But now here jump if not 0 to down, because 7 minus 5 is 2, so 0 flag will not be set. Compare instruction basically performs the subtraction operation to check whether they are equal or not. So jump if not 0 to down, so it will come here and display message 3. Message 3 is strings are not equal. As their lengths are not equal, definitely they are not equal strings. Okay, so just to consider or just to see the instructions, what will happen if the strings are equal, we will consider another example. Let's consider that both strings are equal and they contain the string hello. STR1 is also hello and STR2 is also hello. So now we will directly start from here. Move CL comma STR1 plus 1. So STR1 plus 1 is the length of the STR1. It will contain 5. Move CH comma STR2 plus 1. Here the string length of STR2 plus 1 is also 5. So CH is 5. Compare CH comma CL. So now CH and CL are compared. Compared means subtraction is done. 5 minus 5 is 0. So jump if not 0 to down. So it will not go down, because now the subtraction is 0. That means 0 flag is set. So it will come here, move CH comma 00. Move CH comma 00. Move CL comma STR 1 plus 1. Again, the length of STR 1 is transferred to CL. CL contains 5. LEA SI comma STR 1. So now SI is pointing to STR 1. LEA DI comma STR 2. DI is pointing to STR 2. REPE compare SB. That means repeat if equal. Here we have used repeat until 0. Means repeat if not 0. Repeat if CX is not 0. Move contents from SI to DI. Here repeat if equal. Compare SB. Means check whether the characters are equal, and if equal, repeat the procedure. Okay. So what will happen? First it will check this character and this character. Yes, they are equal. They are equal means here CX is 0005. They are equal means CX is reduced by 1. CX will be 4. SIDI will be incremented. Now again this and this is checked. Yes, they are equal. CX will be decremented by 1. SIDI will point to next position. Again they are equal, so CX will be reduced by 1 and SIDI will point to next position. Again they are equal, so again CX will be reduced by 1, SIDI will be, this is happening with this just single instruction. Again this is equal, CX will be reduced by 1, 0, 0. But now CX is 0, 0 means it will come out of this instruction, because CX is 0, 0 means this compare SB, move SB instruction will come out. Okay, jump if not a 0 to down. So it will come out of this instruction either if the character is not equal, because it is written here repeat until equal. So if character is, let's say if it is H E L L O and here it is H E L L C, so at this point they are not equal, so it will come out, but CX will be 1. So jump if not 0 to down, if they are not 0 means if the instruction is break, as the strings are not equal or character is not equal, that means that strings are not equal. But if this is 0, it means that it has processed the entire string and it has not found any unequal characters. So jump if not 0 to down, but here CX is 0, 0, so it will come here display message 2. What is message 2? Strings are equal. Okay, strings are equal, then return. Return means again it will go here from where it is called this, and again jump menu, so it will execute the menu. Okay, jump menu. Now suppose menu is displayed, and now suppose user enters choice number 4, which is not present. Actually choice number 4 is not present, so AL is 34, BL is 34. So 34 it is compared with 31, it is not 31, it will come here 32, not 32, 33, not 32, not 33. So it will display message 7. Message 7 is enter correct choice, and it will again jump to the menu. See, enter correct choice, and then it will again jump to the menu. It will again display menu. Now let's consider that user entered 3. So AL is 33, BL 33. So compare BL, 33. Jump if equal to terminate. So here code for termination is written. Terminate. Move AH, 4CH, INT 21H. And your program will come out of the execution. And end start and end to end your program. To end your code. Okay. This is all about how FAR procedure is implemented. We have seen string manipulation function to see the execution of FAR procedure. Thank you very much. Students, if you like my videos, please click the like button. You can ask me your queries through comment section, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for latest updates and more videos. Thank you very much.